Hi, I'm Rachel, the Messy Minimalist, and today is perhaps one of the most exciting days on my journey so far. Today is the day that I'm gonna bust into my garage. Today's the day we're getting into the garage. Woo! I'm really pumped, and I'm pumped for tons of reasons, but the biggest reason is because I know I've been putting it off, and I feel like now there's no more excuses. It just has to get done. So today's the day. This is happening. I'm currently sitting on a sofa that we've already pulled out of there. There's much more to be pulled out, and I have no idea what kind of dent we're gonna make in there today, but one thing that I do want to mention is I frequently get people commenting about how hard it is to just get started sometimes. I completely understand and agree. Sometimes getting started is just the hardest part. I definitely feel that way. Actually, I think that's part of what's really prevented me from getting into my garage. And it's just that, you know, one, it's been really cold out. And so, you know, now it's finally warming up and I finally feel like I can open the doors and not freeze my butt off. So that's one thing. But really at the same time, I know a big reason that it's been really easy to put off is because it's just hard to get started when there's something that feels so overwhelming. It doesn't matter if the mess is a big mess or a little mess, we can all feel overwhelmed just the same. For me, the garage is just overwhelming and getting started is, I think, hard. So I just decided to make an example of myself because I always know that after the fact, I'm like, oh, you know, it's true. Getting started was the hardest part. Once you just do it, it's so much easier. So that's what I'm doing today. I'm just basically going to accept that I know getting started sucks sometimes and you just got to get over it. Practice what you preach. And I'm preaching that you just got to do it. So I'm just going to do it. I'm going to open the door and I'm going to see what stuff we can donate. It's time to reclaim that garage. Probably a lot of you watching have icky, awful garages too. And your garage deserves better. You deserve better. There's no reason that we all have a huge space that we can't even use. You know? I know that not everybody cares about my touchy-feely stuff. Just to touch on why I feel that this is so important. I am done having square footage in my house that's filled with unusable space. I'm done with storing things that I never see and I never use, with things that might have had value if I knew what they were. And I'm done having stuff sitting in there knowing that even if I don't want it, I know that somebody else can make good use of them. It just might not be me, and that's okay. And you know, and I want my garage back. I feel like I deserve to park my car in there. I paid to have that garage. I live in a place with some of the worst winters. So without further ado, I'm going to try to prove to myself and to you guys that sometimes getting started is the hardest part. Sometimes you just need to say, screw it. I'm opening up that garage door and I'm going to find some stuff. And I am not going to be done until this trailer is filled with stuff to be donated. Come on with me. Alrighty, well, my plan was to just push everything out, but I'm so eager to just start categorizing things that I have to stop the camera and just talk about some of the stuff that I'm already finding. It's gonna be interesting because I think that one of the reasons that, you know, myself and probably others put stuff in their garage and hoard stuff in their garage or their basements is because when they put them in there, the thing had some sort of value to them, you know, typically. Like, you wouldn't have put it in there if you didn't find value in it, at least at the time. So as I'm digging through things, I'm already finding a lot of stuff of like, oh yeah, I do like that. I'm realizing that it's gonna be a lot harder than I thought, but I still feel like you just gotta break the ice. And I know for me, breaking the ice means finding that first item that I know I'm gonna get rid of, to break the ice and be ready to start getting rid of stuff. First item is a bulletin board. Still functional, I don't need it. This is officially the beginning of all the items that I'm gonna get rid of, hopefully. This is going in the donate pile. Here's something that is kind of a just coming to terms with thing. I realize it's not that exciting, but this means something, not because it's sentimental, but because it's an open ream of paper where you can see the flecks of fiber and stuff in it. There's actually two reams. They're both open. Clearly, like, two sheets have been used out of each one. I have problems getting rid of paper because I've been the kind of person my whole life who likes to sketch things and draw on things and whatever. We've had these for a long time. I mean, they've traveled with us from house to house and location to location, and it's just ridiculous. I'm going to donate to our daycare because I think our daycare will actually use it, and they can do stuff with you know, scrap paper, and the kids can draw on it. And I just think they're going to get a lot more use out of it than us. So, this is going to the daycare. Oops. I need to go get a garbage can. Pair of boots. I believe these were mine when I was a kid. We've probably kept them for a long time because, I don't know actually why we kept them. Cowboy boots. Going bye-bye. What we have here is a really pretty lamp stand, rod, I don't, frame. I'm actually not sure what you call this, but it did at one point have a pretty stained glass lamp attached to it that broke. And I've just been hoarding on to this one because I think there was this part of me that thought that one day I'd get a new shade for it, but I'm not going to get a new shade for it. This thing's been sitting in here for a long time. I think it's just a memory of what was once a pretty lamp, but is no longer. I don't even know if this can get donated, actually. It's like nobody else is going to want to take my chore. If you guys have any ideas of what can be done with things like this, let me know. There's never a shortage of pens in our house. I have an issue with pens. Do you ever have it where you go and you're looking around the house for a pen and then you find a pen and you're like, oh, but I don't like this one? You probably just don't need that pen then. If you actually are going to be picky about what pen you write with, just chuck the pens you don't like and only keep pens you like. I'm not even going to go through them because I already know that I've got a great selection of pens upstairs. I don't need any more pens. Chuck. Okay, I spoke too soon because there was 50 cents in there, which I'm keeping, and there was a marble that I'm giving to my daughter's marble collection. Wooden bowl. This I am gonna keep. It is strangely sentimental. So I'm gonna go ahead and set a goal for myself that if I don't have a plant in this in like 2 months, then I'm gonna chuck it. Do you ever find stuff and you wonder why you have it? Basket full of broken things. Old binky cap to a bottle that I kept breast milk in. The only thing that can be salvaged is the basket, and the basket I'm going to donate. So glad I kept this reusable Target bag with a bunch of holes in it. It's like permanently windblown. It doesn't even look real. The fibers are just fraying on every branch. Such a bummer! A coat that I actually love. It's one of my winter coats, but I wondered what happened to this. Like, I actually thought I lost this, and then boom, there it is. Donate. Okay. I think that we just stumbled upon a tote of stuff that was actually supposed to be donated, but never got donated. That was the old me. The old me would put a bunch of stuff and feel really good about donating it, and then it would get lost in the house. Here we are. I end up storing it for a year or longer. I don't even really want to look at it, to be honest. I actually kind of fear that I'm going to find something that I want to keep in here. I'm determined that no matter what I see in here, I can't choose to keep anything. Dang! Curlers. I'm thinking about giving my curlers one more spin. Ooh, cool vintage mail organizer, which is really lovely. Really cute vintage piece that I love, but it does not bring me joy. I will post this on my Facebook page if anybody wants to claim it. Yeah, now I know why I chose to donate this stuff. What's in there? I think there's cat food in there. Yeah, donate. Agreed? A missing puzzle piece to my daughter's puzzle that's sitting upstairs. I will pocket that so she can have her puzzle piece back. This actually is for putting sponges in at your kitchen sink. It's cute, and I am ready to pass it on to somebody else. So, frankly, I don't need to see my face this close.
Whoa.
Classic. This is a bag of boot wipes that somehow I was tricked into buying. I got them back in 2012, maybe? They're long since gone. The boot wipes remain because they were useless. Nobody needs to buy special wipes to wipe down their boots. It's ridiculous. I think I probably paid like $9 for these, and they've been sitting with me now for years. A percentage of you watching has to struggle with this. And no, it's not just because it's a lampshade. It's the what if item. The what if item is the thing that you keep around because you just never know if you're going to need it. Because it seems nice, it's in great condition, why would you get rid of it? Because you might need it. Well, I too have kept this around because I might need it. We waited too long, we couldn't return it. The point is, we're like, but it's a great shade. Maybe one of these days we'll get a lamp that we need for it. I don't even know what we were thinking. I've held this around because I thought, what if I need it one day? I'm frankly just tired of waiting. I feel like that one day is not here yet. I don't feel like waiting anymore for it. Okay, I have a confession, like a big time confession. I hoard picture frames with a really unrealistic idea of putting them up on the wall. Yeah. My husband makes fun of me for it, and I let him, and I continue to say every time that it gets brought up that one day I will have a gallery wall with more pictures in it. The problem is it just never happens. It straight up never happens. This is just a small handful of these picture frames that you can see. They come in all sizes. You just don't know what you're gonna get. What color, what finish. It doesn't matter. Some are wood, some are plastic, some are a typical size, some are an atypical size. There's a lot of them. I don't even know, but yeah, I have a problem. I don't even have pictures to put in them. I think there was this part of me that thought that one day I would print out a bunch of wedding photos and hang up our beautiful wedding photos, but yeah, I'm gonna donate these. And more. And more. It is something that I do like, and it's been buried in here. It's time to resurrect it, so I'm keeping this. But I'm not keeping this because it's a fax machine. Seriously? I'm gonna donate them. Kind of cute decorations. Just dropping little tiny micro beads, polluting the planet. There we go. Because you can never have too many CD-ROM cases. This is a nice bonus pack of 50. Fancy. These are chess pieces. They're made out of marble. Made in Mexico. Some of them are broken. Ooh, well now they're definitely broken. Dang it. Actually, surprisingly, it's only chipped. Lava lamp. I don't even recognize this. This might not even be ours. This is the problem. It's like when you start unearthing things that you haven't seen in a long time, it actually makes you question your own sanity. Yeah, obviously, you know, I'm not keeping this. Okay. So this is a really sweet antique table I just treated like crap. Somehow managed to get some stuff like royally stuck to the top of it. I think it's a really sweet piece, but it's gonna need some serious work on the top, and I'm not really sure if I'm ready to put that work into this piece or if I should just get rid of it. So I'm going to set this aside, determine if I think I'm up for sanding it down and repainting it. We'll go from there. I mean, what do they cost? Like 50 cents? Dollar, maybe? They're so gross with spider webs and stuff, there's always this part of me that's like, well, what if I'm gonna need a good 89-cent binder? You do know, and it's that you don't need them. Break, sipped some coffee, had a good think, and I'm not going to keep two of the things that I said I was going to keep because that's not the point of this journey. I didn't just say I was going to go look through everything just so I could simmer on everything. I'm going to get rid of stuff. This set of curlers that I was going to keep, nope, I'm not going to keep it. I don't need it. I don't want it. I'm donating it. Same with this table, which I do love and I do think is sweet and I don't want to be wasteful, but you know what? When it's being donated, somebody else can make a good home out of it. I don't want to have another honey-do list item. I don't want it on my list. I just straight up don't want to deal with it. So both of these things are going in the donate pile right now. So another little check-in here. I'm not even close to being done. It really does just get messier before it gets cleaned. That is just the way that it always is for me. But stuff worth noting. It's just stuff that I can, with a clear conscience, say it doesn't bring me joy. For anyone who doesn't know what this is, it's adorable. Specifically, it is something that you put on top of stuff when you're having a picnic to keep the bees and flies and bugs out of your dish. In theory, it's practical. It's just one of those things that seemed cute at the time, but is really, to me, just a waste of space. I don't know what it is with me and faces. I think I felt like I liked it. Yeah. Dishes that could have candy in them or fruit or I don't know, whatever other knickknacks, but not knickknacks that I need to have. I love it. The most obvious pieces of artwork. Chair. Light. Thank you for letting me know what these things are. Ew. Spider webs and spider eggs and all kinds of gross stuff. We all sort of chase this idea of... I'm not actually sure really what these were chasing. When things are cheap, they oftentimes seem more appealing, and then you buy them because they were such a good deal, and you get them home and you realize that, like, I don't really like them at all. Bought these a long time ago, don't really care about them, going to get rid of them. And then a lot of fake plants. I don't really have any comment here. Butterfly. It's quality made, it's kind of got a good weight to it. It's just a nice piece, but I've made my decisions. I looked through decorations a long time ago. I decided what I wanted and didn't want. Clearly this never made the cut. It's not making the cut again. This might make it onto my Facebook page. If somebody else is interested, I think that it's probably worth at least $5. If someone wants it for $5, go to my Facebook page and grab it. And then these things, which I think are too heavy to ship to anybody, so they're just gonna go to Goodwill, but pretty pot, kind of interesting clock. Thank you. So, I've had some highs and some lows, and hopefully for you guys, you just got to see a nice sped up version of what to me was hours and hours of just like, ugh. I had a lot of breaks in there because I needed them. I have a few more items to show. There is a story with this. I'm not okay with fur, but I'm showing it because I'm just being real. It was in there and I've had it for a long time. And like I said, I'm ashamed that as a kid, I didn't know better. I don't have anything good to say about it. I don't think it's right to kill poor animals for their fur. I think it's supposed to be like a scarf or something that wealthy people would wear back in the day. I don't even know. Anyway, throw pillow that was never used, then just a bunch of junk, like these bottles that, yeah, don't even ask me why I have them. Oh, jeez. And then some really big chairs. I don't know, can you guys see the chairs right there? I barely made a dent in there. I mean, there's still so far to go in there. I just look at it and I feel overwhelmed. But the good news is I filled up the trailer. And you know what? That's the best we can hope for. I do feel a little bit lighter knowing that I got rid of some of the stuff that's just been sitting there. I'm not sad to see it go at all. I've got four more bays of the garage to get through. So hopefully that's not as hard for me to get started on as this was. And I guess just kind of to recap, you know, the thing that we talked about earlier, which was just sometimes getting started is the hardest part. That was true today. It's true a lot of the times. And sometimes you just have to force yourself into it. It might even be easier for me right now. In my mind, I'm like, well, I have to show everybody what I'm doing. So I almost have that little bit of extra motivation that maybe you guys don't have. But if it does help to motivate you, I always really, really love it when people comment and talk about what they were able to get through. You can join my Facebook page. Anyone can post pictures of decluttering that they're doing or whatever it is. And I get it. It's not like a huge community of others. But if you do post it there, I'll be rooting you on. And seriously, I think sometimes just having a buddy who you feel like is in it with you, it's just helpful. So anyway, hopefully you guys feel like you can maybe go and just get started on whatever project it was that you felt like you just couldn't get started on. Who knows, maybe you will make as big of a dent as I did, or an even bigger dent than I did. Sometimes getting started is the hardest part. All we can do is push through it. I will be back in my garage again soon. Thank you guys for joining me for the long-awaited and hopefully not anticlimactic garage purge video. I liked having you guys with me. Hope you liked it too. If you aren't a subscriber and you've made it to this point, then please consider subscribing and you can keep following along as I declutter my home and become a more minimal person. Thanks again, and I'll talk to you guys later.